change, the solution for humanity.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. أما بعد, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward you for putting the time and the effort towards trying to understand Allah's beautiful names more and more. Or perhaps you already know all of this, but just trying to remind yourself, and may Allah bless you and reward you for that, and the whole ummah, Ameen Rabbil Alameen. And I'd love to begin with making dua for my brothers and sisters that are putting the time, because I'm, once again, time is very precious and you're allowing me some of your time. So I thank you for trusting me with that very precious thing which you have. And bi-ithnillah, I fulfilled my duty in a way that Allah is pleased with. And inshallah, you, bi-ithnillah, also are pleased with. Now, inshallah, we will talk about a new set of names by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a name that because of its existence, we were able to understand all of Allah's beautiful names. It is a name that perhaps most Muslims, if not all Muslims, know about it. If they don't know the name itself, but they definitely know the attribute of that name, it's a name that whenever you make da'wah, you need to make sure that, number one, this name is established in the heart of the person you're making da'wah to. So for example, a person may come to you who is non-Muslim and argues about the hijab of the sister. Is it an obligation or is it not an obligation? And back and forth and back and forth in trying to convince them. But the main point is, you need to know and ask them first, not ask them, but need to know. Do they believe in Allah to begin with? If they're non-Muslim, yes, ask them. If they're non-Muslim, ask them first. Do you believe in the existence of a creator? Do you believe in Allah al-Khaliq? And that's the beautiful name of today. Do you believe there's a Khaliq, there's a creator to all of this? If the person says no, then there's no point in moving forward in any point of da'wah when that person doesn't even believe there's a creator. Because this is the first thing needs to be established for us to move forward. Because had we know there's a creator, then definitely that creation has a purpose of why it's here, and the Quran, and then the Sunnah, then we can talk about the hijab, the salah, the beard, the meat issue, and all that stuff. But this needs to be established. And with this being said, we will talk about Allah's beautiful names, which is four of them, inshallah. Al-Khaliq, Al-Bari', Al-Musawwir, and Al-Khalaq, the creator, the inventor, the fashioner, and the supreme creator. Have you ever remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Al-Khaliq and it caused you to cry? Have you ever remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Al-Khaliq, the creator? Allah made you, Allah created you, and you felt so shy that how can I use this hand which Allah Al-Khaliq created, Al-Musawwir, has fashioned and designed? How can I use the same blessing in a way that is against him? Did you ever think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Khaliq and your iman went up? Brothers and sisters, when I talk about thinking, understanding Allah's beautiful names, especially in this one right now, I'm talking about a different kind of acknowledgement. There are two kinds. The first one in which most people agree to, most people, even the people that are not Muslim necessarily, different religions. Number one is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admitting that he's a creator who created the heavens and the earth. That's the first thing that we need to make sure it's all in our hearts. Allah says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولئن سألتهم من خلق السماوات والأرض ليقولن الله. And if you were to ask them who created the heavens and the earth, they will tell you Allah. Even many non-Muslims believe in this. But we're trying to understand Allah's names in a way that goes beyond this basic understanding that should be firm in our hearts, which is that feeling of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He is Al-Khaliq, that will cause you to love Him, that will cause you to have haya, how can I sin against Him, that will cause you that Allah, oh my Creator, so you feel very humble towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and because Allah is a Creator, you feel that you have a purpose in existence on this earth, and there's something that you shall accomplish while you were here. When you think of Allah al-Khaliq, there's much more than just Allah created everything, but we're talking about love, haya, humbleness, and a purpose that me and you need to fulfill. Now let's look at some of the definitions and some explanations of these beautiful names. Number one, Allah al-Khaliq. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah al-Hashr, Al-Khaliq al-Bari' al-Musawwir is the ayah that we mentioned in one of the introduction parts of the series. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Khaliq, what does it mean? The one who has created something out of something else, or created something out of simply nothing. Alladhi yakhluq min al-adam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ خَالِقُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your Lord, the one who created everything. La ilaha illahu. There's no deity worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the logic that comes afterwards, that since Allah created everything, absolutely everything, then definitely He is the commander. Allah says in the Quran, أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ. Isn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the one who created, is the one who commands? Makes sense. He created, so He's the one who commands. Another simple fact, Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. O people, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has created you. He is the one who made you, so worship Him. Who are you worshiping besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? To whom are you sharing your intention when you do a good deed besides Allah al-Khaliq? How could you? Don't you have haya? Aren't you humble towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then how can I sin against Him? How can I be arrogant when you were nothing and I was nothing and we were all nothing? Just like Allah said, هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. Didn't a time come when the insan, the human being, was nothing? Absolutely, yes, Ya Allah, that time did come, Ya Allah, and we never existed at one point in time. And now we come to this dunya, so arrogant. A'udhu billah. Allah al-Khaliq shall cause me and you to humble ourselves. Now let's look now at Allah's beautiful name, Al-Bari. Al-Bari, the initiator. Now Al-Bari, you might see different definitions. I'll mention two with you, inshallah. Number one, Al-Bari is the one who is free from faults and initiated things in a way that are perfect. One time I said that in a halaqa back in Canada, and a brother told me, well, if Allah is Al-Bari and He created everything with perfection and He's free from faults, then why are there people that are handicapped? Why are there people that were born with faults? SubhanAllah, we all need to pay attention. Allah doesn't do mistakes because He is Al-Bari. Allah doesn't do mistakes because He is Al-Bari, because He is Al-Khaliq, because He is Al-Musawwir, because He is Allah. So when Allah creates someone with handicap, being in a handicapped situation, Allah perfectly designed him in a way that Allah intended this person to come into life. So Allah wants that person to come, for example, with one hand to dunya. And Allah perfectly designed it in that way, subhanAllah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us in a way that will be ibnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in a way that Allah, the wise, Al-Hakim, knows best. So we shall not complain from Al-Bari, but we can complain to Al-Bari. And when you complain to Allah about your weakness, Allah will reward you. But make sure you don't complain from Allah, like, why Allah, you've given me this figure and this feature, etc. Now Allah Al-Bari, another meaning that can come to it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Al-Bari is the one who created His creation in ways that befits their purpose in life. Let me explain that to you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the angels out of what? Out of what? Mud? Out of fire? No, out of light. So Allah Al-Bari creates them out of light for them to serve their purpose of existence. So the angels, they're made out of nur. They carry the message and they protect the believers. We are made out of clay, out of mud. Why? Because clay is a sign of construction, mud, building. And we are here as a khalifa to construct and build goodness on this earth. So Al-Bari creates us in a way that befits our purpose into this dunya, into existence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Al-Musawwir, the supreme fashioner. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Al-Musawwir comes in place when it's coming into the final figure and shape. So the last touches, when it comes to the color of your eyes, when it comes to the color of your skin, your height, your width, your length, and all that good stuff. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, هو الذي يصوركم في الأرحام كيف يشاء. Allah is the one who fashions you in the womb of your mother in the way that Allah wants. You know how beautiful this ayah is? That when you walk around the face of this earth, I want you to understand this ayah, and I need to also understand and believe that I've been designed the way Allah wants. So Allah made me, Allah designed me. And Allah is the best of designers. Allah is the best of fashioners. Allah is, طبعاً, المصور. And sometimes when you translate the word into English, it kind of loses the beauty, but we'll stick with Allah, المصور. So be proud. I was designed, I was fashioned by المصور, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't complain about your nose. Don't complain about your nose. Long, big, short, like this, like that. Your ears, like this. Doesn't matter. Allah designed me. Be proud. Allah al-Musawwir. And wallahi, we seek Allah's closeness by these beautiful names. Ya Allah, I am pleased with the way you fashioned me, Allah. I'm not going to complain why my beard is curly and why my hair is straight. I'm not going to complain that maybe I'm too white. Or, for example, some people will complain, I'm so black. We shall not complain. Allah al-Musawwir fashioned me and you in a way that it pleases Him. Allah is okay with it. Allah likes it. Allah wills that this to happen. Then let it be. Is it clear? And we shall not change the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has fashioned us. The last name of the episode, which we're going to discuss further inshallah, is Allah's name Al-Khalaq. Now, you might ask a question, what's the difference between Al-Khaliq and Al-Khalaq? Now, Al-Khalaq, if it would be translated, it would be the supreme creator. Al-Khalaq, when there's a lot of creation happening. So when you go back and forth in creation, when we die and come back to resurrection, you use Allah's name Al-Khalaq. When you talk about the number of the angels, you perhaps can use Allah's name Al-Khalaq when there's excess in creation. Let me tell you the ayah that mentions that name, and let me tell you the hadith behind this. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and don't forget to say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man by the name of Al-As bin Wa'il al-Sahmi, who was a kafir, he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he had some bones, and he crushed the bones until they became crumbled and they became dust. Pay attention. He grabbed some bones and they crushed the bones until it became like dust. Then he went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَفَتَحَ بِيَدِهِ. So he opened his hand. And he said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَيُحْيِي اللَّهُ هَذِهِ بَعْدَ مَا أَرَى. Will Allah bring this person who came from that bone basically, whoever used these bones to be alive, will this be resurrected and come back and everything will be constructed and that living thing will come back to life? What will the Prophet respond? Or what did the Prophet respond? We will see inshallah after this short break. Please stay tuned for the beautiful response from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazakumullah khairah. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Marriage or divorce?
What's Islamic ruling?
Nikah.
Solution or problem? Heaven or hell?
There is a misconception.
You choose. Beauty, wealth, family status, virtue. Decide what you want. Decide your choice. Be sad or be happy. It's your choice. Join Dr. Zakir Naik in Better Half or Bitter Half every Friday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. Eastern Time on Peace TV. Osama El Shami.
How can we get our children ready for the month of Ramadan?
Sharing the stories of what the Muslims have been through in the past, in particular the first generation.
Nazir Irfan Al Mujahid.
Make this Ramadan
very special to them.
Your taqwa, your righteousness, your goodness.
I want you to tell me about your experiences from the very first Ramadan that you experienced as a new Muslim.
The first Ramadan I experienced was amazing.
Umar Debua.
When I embraced Islam, it was like I was prepared. You know, Allah prepared me for something that I had no idea. It was an amazing experience.
Beautiful. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to our program, The Straight Path.
Build your character on the path of the Quran and Sunnah. In The Straight Path. Next on Peace TV.
Bam, bam.
Hey kids, time is very precious.
This life is a gift from Allah.
Utilize this gift for here and hereafter.
Enjoy this gift in the light of the Quran and Hadith.
Enjoy Islam with us, Zain and Dawood.
Enjoying Islam with Zain and Dawood. Tomorrow at 7:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 10:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakum Allah khair for being patient and during that break and going back again and continuing with Allah's beautiful names, Al-Khaliq and Al-Bari, Al-Musawwir and Al-Khalaq. May Allah bless you. Allah Al-Khalaq, when that man Al-As bin Wa'il Al-Sahmi came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with that crumbled bones and the dust and asked, will Allah bring this back to life? Will the one who used these bones to be in existence will come back to life? Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, because that man, by the way, that man Al-As was known to be very, very arrogant and he was making fun and being sarcastic. So he wants an answer that humbles him down. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with his wisdom and knowledge, he responds in a way that befits that person. And he said, Na'am, Allah will bring this back to life. Na'am, yumituka Allah. Yes, Allah will make you die. Thumma yuhyik, thumma yudkhiluka nara jahannam. Yes, Allah will make you die and will make you resurrected and then will enter you into jahannam. Subhanallah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a verse and Allah says, أَوَلَيْسَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ بِقَادِرٍ عَلَىٰ أَن يَخْلُقَ مِثْلَهُمْ. Allah says, isn't the one who created the heavens and the earth able to create like them? Can't Allah, the one who created 10 million people, create another 10 million? Can't Allah who created a billion angels create another billion? The answer, Allah says, Allah answers, بَلَىٰ نَعَمْ بَلَا وَهُوَ الْخَلَّاقُ الْعَلِيمُ. And Allah is the supreme creator, the all knowledgeable. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with these names coming into place, why not go back in time to appreciate Allah al-Khaliq, to appreciate how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created things. Let's go all the way back in time. During Adam alayhi salam, no, a little back in time. The jinn before the jinn. The angels before the angels. The pen before the pen. It was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there was no one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كَانَ اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْءٌ قَبْلُهُ. It was Allah and there was no one before Allah. It was Allah alone and there was nothing there. I wasn't there. You weren't there. The earth was not there. The angels were not there. The jinn was not there. Allah's throne was not there. Nothing was there. كان الله ولم يكن شيء قبله. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, هو الأول. Allah is the first. And it's another beautiful name of Allah. Allah is the first. هو الأول والآخر. Allah is the first and Allah is the last. Subhanallah. How can we be arrogant after that? We were nothing. I'm going to keep repeating this because the purpose of this talk, when you remember Allah al-Khaliq, al-Bari, al-Musawwir, al-Khalaq, it shall cause you to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's a relationship between us and Him. He's our creator and we are the creation. There is this strongest relationship on the face of this earth. The relationship between the slave and the master. Not any master in dunya, but our master Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That will cause you to have a lot of haya. How can I sin against Him? How can I disrespect Him? That will cause you to be humble towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You feel so humbled, al-inkisar, khushu' and khashya. And then you will say, Ya Allah, You created me for a purpose. I will fulfill that purpose, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ. Were they created by nothing? Or were they themselves the creator? So you either came from nowhere or created your own self. But definitely, we didn't make our own selves. And definitely, we didn't come out of nothing. Someone must have made us, and it was none but Allah al-Khaliq. Allah says, أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ بَلْ لَا يُوقِنُونَ. Or did they create the heavens and the earth? Ya Allah, of course they did not. Ya Allah, it is none but You. And everyone shall believe in this. I learned a beautiful lesson from one of my shuyukh. He said, when you talk to an atheist about Islam, give him 5 minutes. Just 5 minutes. Don't go over 5 minutes. Because someone that does not believe there's a creator for the creation, that person must be stubborn. There must be something severe wrong with their mind. How can you accept the fact that all of this came out of nothing? Wallahi, as a person who is sane, you would refuse to say that this laptop came here out of nowhere. Just came randomly. The screen came, the keyboard came, they flew or whatever, and came and was designed right here. It's impossible. You would think that person that says that has lost their mind. SubhanAllah, you say impossible. Someone must have put it here. Someone must have designed it. How can we accept such fact on a laptop? And there was heavens and the earth and the mountains and the oceans and the lakes and the birds and the trees. And we say, no one made them? SubhanAllah, 5-minute rule. Allah is the creator, yes or no? Absolutely. That person is stubborn? Khalas, ignore that person. That's why in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't spend so many ayat about atheists, about those that disbelieve in Allah. But Allah talks a lot with the Christians, with the Jews, who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they have a different in terms of aqidah, etc. But existence, it's clear to them. Is it clear? There's something for us to comprehend. So number one, it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no one before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, what came next? Now, there's a lot of difference of opinion, and inshallah, I tried to get some of the ulama, and you might find different orders, but they're all authentic hadith. That's very important. Every hadith I'm mentioning is authentic, but sometime you might find the order, and I tried my best to go see what the ulama have said and grab it for you and put it nicely. So it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and nothing before Him. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the water. What's the proof? The water was the first thing Allah created. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in authentic hadith, كُلُّ شَيْءٍ خُلِقَ مِنْ مَاءٍ. And Allah said in the Quran, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. And we made every living thing out of water. So water is an essential thing for every living thing. And the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that everything was made out of water. Okay, what came after the water? What do you think? Huh? What do you think came after the water? What came after the water, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كَانَ اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْءٌ قَبْلُهُ وَكَانَ عَرْشُهُ عَلَى الْمَاءِ. There was Allah and there was nothing before Him. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the throne above the water. SubhanAllah. So it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the water. The water is the essence of every other creation. Then Allah created the throne. What came next? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ أَوَّلَ مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ الْقَلَمُ. The first thing Allah created, now the ulama say after the water and after the throne, after all of that, Allah created the pen. How does the pen look like? Allahu A'lam. What color? Allahu A'lam. Does it even have a color? Allahu A'lam. But Allah created the pen. Let's stop right here. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the pen. Allah told the pen, write, uktub. The pen asked Allah, Ya Rabb, wa ma'adha aktub? Oh Allah, oh my Lord, what shall I write? Allah said, اكتب مقادير كل شيء حتى تقوم الساعة. Write about everything and to what will be decreed until the يوم القيامة. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, another hadith to confirm this, he said, كتب الله مقادير الخلائق. Allah has written everything that will be decreed on the people, on the creation, قبل أن يخلق السماوات والأرض بخمسين ألف سنة. Before the creation of the heavens and the earth, by 50,000 years. قَالَ وَعَرْشُهُ عَلَى الْمَاءِ. And they said that Allah's throne is above water. See all of this being prepared, and me and you are still not there. We're still not even there yet, subhanAllah. And all of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing the universe for us to come here to worship Allah, to understand Allah's beautiful names. Now what came next? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. Allah said in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth and whatever is in between in how many days? In سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ, 6 days. وَمَا مَسَّنَا مِنْ لُغُوبٍ. And we were not tired, we were not fatigued by this creation. Now subhanAllah, why do many verses state that it has been created in 6 days? Why 6 days? For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach me and you that change requires time. Change doesn't happen overnight. Change will need effort, will need sacrifice, will need a lot of time for things to come in the best case. Allah could have said, kun fayakun. Allah doesn't need 6 days. Allah could have said, be, and it will be. But Allah is teaching me and you a very important lesson in this dunya, that change requires patience. And now if you look at the verse right after Allah said, I created the heavens and the earth in 6 days, and I was not fatigued by it, Allah said, fasbir, and be patient. See the connection? Fasbir ala ma yaqulun. So be patient for what they are saying. فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ. And remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the morning and the evening. Do your adhkar in the morning and in the evening. This is the proof that you can use. So this would remind you of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be patient. And you ask Allah in the morning to protect you. You ask Allah at the night to protect you and allow you to achieve the goals of your day, and bi'idhnillah to die in a state of Islam. And inshallah, we will move forward in the next episode talking about our creation, about the angels, about the ruh, and much more inshallah in the next few episodes. So please be patient. I'll see you inshallah next episode. Barakallah feekum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Praise be to my Lord Allah. Praise Him every day. Say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. God is great. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. God is great. God is great.
The hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu anfiqu mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya yawmun la bay'un fihi wa la khullatun wa la shafa'a.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Peace TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause, the proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK, B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. SWIFT BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace Team, the solution for humanity.